या लाइफ ट्रेनर।
नमस्ते एंड वेलकम एवरीवन टू येट अनदर एडिशन ऑफ इवॉल्व आर एसएस लीडरशिप टॉक शो वेयर आर लीडर्स शेयर देयर एक्सपीरियंसेस टू हेल्प अस डेवलप एंड ग्रो। माय नेम इज प्रेरणा योर होस्ट एंड दोस्त फॉर द डे। देयर आर वेरी फ्यू पीपल हु इंस्पायर अस विद अ स्ट्रांग सेट ऑफ वैल्यूज हु आर द टॉर्च बियरर्स ऑफ नॉट जस्ट अ लेगेसी बट आर ऑल्सो डीपली पैशनेट अबाउट everything they do. Today we have amongst us someone who's an inspiration, someone who strongly believes in what he does and does what he believes in tirelessly, a leader, a mentor, and our speaker for today, Mr. Souvik Bose, Zonal Controller North. Welcome, sir, to the show.
Thank you. Thanks, Prerna, and a very good evening to all the team members in the audience and everyone who has joined for this small session. So first of all, I would want to thank Shopper Stop and Team HR for organizing such an interesting session on Leadership Talk under the banner name of Evolve. I did get a chance to see some of my colleagues and peer group in these kind of sessions in the last couple of days. I think it's really very innovative and refreshing way for many of us to hear what's happening in each other's life and what has happened, things which we did not know. I think I got to know many of those things from my colleagues. I think it's a fantastic platform where we connect with the team members and share small things from our life, and hopefully this adds some learning and some value to the people who are attending these talks. I sincerely hope and pray that all our family members in the store at home are keeping very safe and healthy. And yes, Prerna.
So we had a lot of questions to ask from you. I'm going to take a few of them today. So the first would be, sir, we would want to know more about your life, your family, education, professional life, moving on to Shop to Stop. How did it all begin?
Okay. Let me first give us a quick preview of my personal life. So I have spent more than half of my age with my parents, and my father being in F4, so I was always called the defense kid. So my upbringing has been in the defense background, and with my parents I always had a very simplistic life, and as traditional families of the country, I think the focus was on good value system, our own culture. At home, academics was top priority, doing good in studies. And I always used to love sports a lot, be it any kind of sports. I used to really love in my school days and my college sports a lot. I have a younger brother and a younger sister. I'm the elder one at home, and both of them are married. And they're settled, very well settled, and doing very well for themselves professionally. My father is currently retired, and my father and mom, both of them stay in very close by in Faridabad. Being from a defense background, I've got a fantastic chance to see many places, live in many places with my parents, and now professionally as well. And I think learning, India being such a diverse country, such rich heritage and culture, I think learning and adapting to various cultures and people has been always in my blood, which I got it from my father. I'm married now, and I have a daughter. My wife, she is a housewife, and my daughter, she is in class 8, and we currently stay in Noida. So that's a quick one in my life. On my education front, Being from defense background, I think most of us have done their schooling from Kendra Vidyalaya. So I did my complete schooling from Kendra Vidyalaya, various places. For my college years, I had to split it up between Madras, so now it's called as Chennai. And so my father got posted out of Chennai during my college days, and I finished my college, some part of it in Chennai and the other part in Faridabad. Post that, I did my post-graduation in marketing and finance. So academically, if you ask me, I was not a very strong kid, but I was always a very smart kid. So I ensured that jab time sahi tha tab padhai kiya. So 10th, 12th, and my PG years, I really slogged and ensured that I had good and better marks, so that those things in Indian education system really helps to open some doors. But yes, nowadays we have a school group, college group, and we always keep talking about, if we had a chance, we would go back to the school days and relive those moments. So yeah, so that's on my family and education right now. What else can I tell you?
I'm sure with so much of work and task at hand, and maybe stress at times, what keeps you going?
Let me tell you about my professional career. I think that's what that's where the life gets a little interesting, and time management and stress. I wouldn't say stress has a, I would say, a negative connotation. I think we all go through certain I would say time crunch or certain stuff like that. So professionally, I started post my first job in my career was with SR Cell Phones, which after some time became Hachintosh Manpower because it was taken over by Hachintosh, and then currently the avatar is called as Vodafone. So I started my professional career with this company, and in my first role in this company, I was given the corporate sales. I was leading the Gurgaon and Faridabad cities during that time. And believe me, being the first job out of college, it was a real fantastic, I would say, good, hardworking, but nice party time of my life. Work hard, party hard, so good time. And this was also a time when India, the country, was seeing mobiles and pages entering our country. And believe me, for most of you, it would be very surprising. When I started, outgoing calls in peak time used to be 16 rupees 80 paisa. I cannot forget that. 16 rupees 80 paisa for calling outgoing calls used to be that. And ye wo time tha jahan pe people used to give missed call to mobile phone users, so that after looking at that number, they would then pick up the landline and call back, because incoming was also 4 rupees 20 paisa. That was the time when I was working in this industry. Because I was in the corporate sales, I really got a fabulous exposure in meeting many of the industry icons. Gurgaon and Faridabad had a lot of big corporates. And I still remember one particular meeting which I had, and this was a meeting which I was planning, plotting, and doing so many things, because I had to get that order. So this was one day in the month of April, peak summer. Bike se utar ke, I used to wear a wind cheater ki white shirt or tie ganda na ho jaye. Haath mun dho ke parking mein bike lagaya wind cheater ko. तब मेरे पास एक स्कूटर हुआ करता था, LML Vespa. So उसमें रखा, I combed my hair and I walked into Mr. Rajan Nanda and Nikhil Nanda's office. So these two, Rajan Nanda, who is no more, he was the MD of Escorts, and Nikhil Ganga is the current MD right now. So I walked into their office, spoke with them for half an hour, 45 minutes, and I'd done some research about them. And when I walked out of their office, I had at that point in time the biggest order for SRR cell phones. I had blocked 500 handsets and 500 connections after a 45 minutes meeting. So that was a big achievement, I would say, for a young lad of 25, 26 to walk into the MD's office of Escort and back such an order. So I had a good time with that company. That was my first company. Suppose that I think I was 26. And at 26, if somebody offers you another 1,500 rupees extra in take home salary, you switch a job. So मुझे अभी भी याद है मैंने 1500 रुपए के लिए monthly, I used to calculate monthly, I switched to the next job, and the name of the company was Netfinix, not Netflix, which we see nowadays. It was called as Netfinix. It was a startup company from NASDAQ Corporation in USA. And they were at that point in time doing financial instruments and investment banking in the country. Again, a very new concept at that year. And unfortunately, the company did not do well, and they were wrapping up. And I left them quickly. Fortunately for me, I shifted the boats before the shutters were down. So I already had a new job in my hand. And that job really changed my professional life. So I moved into G Money. It was called as G Countrywide earlier, then it was named as G Money. And this was the first time in my life I stepped out independently. Before that, I used to stay with my parents. So Indian society is a parents. Mom used to take care of everything, and father used to shield us. But this is the first time I moved out from my house and went to Bangalore with this company. I worked in G Money for, I think, 4.5 years with them, and I started my career in Bangalore, heading the Bangalore city for, this was an NBFC, so I was heading their consumer durable, two-wheeler and personal loans for a while. And within a short span of 3 years, being rated as very well for consecutive years, I was given to handle Karnataka and Kerala. So by the time I left them, I was handling Karnataka and Kerala. So and this was for me first big multinational I was working for, and the kind of learnings and experiences professionally I got from the day-to-day events which I was going through, and especially the leadership interactions I had in this company after attending many workshops and seminars really helped me to sharpen my skills and hone my my overall skills as a professional, as a human being. So really changed my life course in these 4.5 years. And then suddenly one day somebody told me that this company called as Shopper Stop, one of my bosses who was earlier working in G Money had moved a couple of months back. So I was in touch with him, and he had told me that he has gone to Shopper Stop in Bombay, but I did not know what Shopper Stop was. So wo bolte hai na ki kisi dukaan mein kaam kar raha tha. So I think that was the feeling. So one day he told me he's working in Shopper Stop, and he actually educated me, and he told, and he opened and broadened my horizon. And then I started doing some research of what is this company all about, what is retail all about. And this was around 2005-06 when retail, organized retail, I would say, was a sunrise industry, and many people from various industries were getting into retail. And retail was attracting a lot of good talent from and people from cut across industry. So I again, my take home was increasing by a couple of more 1,000 rupees. So take home ke liye maine Shopper Stop joined. So this was in September 2005. So September 2005, I joined Shopper Stop as unit manager for the Chetpet store in Chennai. And So I have some very lovely memories of this tour, because for me, I'm working in Shoppers Stop now, so it's been 15 years. For me, Checkpet Shoppers Stop was the school of retail for me. And this is where I learned about the company, the organization Shoppers Stop. I learned about retail, and I really understood the sweat and blood which is put behind the glamour which is visible to the customer. Because 2005 I joined, and I remember a couple of years back, I think me and my parents had come from Faridabad to Ansal Plaza in Delhi, and we had done some Durga Puja shopping. I don't remember the year. And coming from a very humble background, we were actually very overwhelmed with Shoppers Stop Ansal Plaza. Itna bada dukaan tha, itne achche achche brand rakhe hue the, such smart, good looking boys and girls, and it was South Delhi, the clientele was different. And my father kept on telling me ki matlab is dukaan mein na bahut expensive cheez milta hoga, hum log yahan se nahi khareed payenge. And every time we picked up something, my father, I remember, was doing a mental calculation ki abhi to itna ho gaya, abhi to itna paisa ho gaya. So that was the family or my interaction with Shoppers Stop. In 2005, when I joined Shoppers Stop, my father had forgotten that bit, and I reminded him that, you remember, hum log us dukaan mein gaye the, usi company mein maine join kiya. So we had a very big laugh and discussion. Ki ore bab, tumne us company mein join kiya. He was feeling nice, actually. Before that, he never knew what GE Money was. I was in Bangalore. So we had some connection with Shoppers before that, though it was very intimidating. But yes, that was Shoppers Stop for our family. What Shoppers Stop in Chennai, or the first store, taught me was that there is no replacement in our business for basics. So sticking to basics, I quickly learned it in the first few months in that store, that basics hai jo har samay humko follow karna hai, aur basics hi hai jo humko aage leke jayega in retail. And there was really no rocket science in that store. And whatever I was doing, I learned the basics, I followed the basics, and I still continue to do the basics even today after 15 years of retailing in this company, working with this company. I also learned that this job in the front end was all about loving the monotonous role. Humko wahi cheez roz hafte bhar hafte mahine bhar mahine karna hai, and we have to fall in love of doing monotonous things. So falling in love of a monotonous routine is not a joke. So it is something which we have to develop. Though it is monotonous, but it's really fun. And another thing, the prior roles I had was, though I was leading some teams earlier, but it was not so intensive on human capital. But here I learned it very fast that in retail, the human capital is the first and foremost thing. So people are the most important thing, and there is no replacement for a right team member in the front end. We cannot replace. There cannot be any replacement. We need to have the right kind of people in the front end, because that single individual, he or she, is the final touch point with the customer, where all the things, the strategic and the tactical things which the organization discusses and decides to do, gets delivered. So that one person, boy or girl, they actually make a huge difference for us. So training them, recognizing them, rewarding them was extremely important and paramount in this trade. I really learned it very fast. And they really are the backbone of any retail setup, or maybe organizations also. So in Checkpet, I had a funny thing, and I think on a lighter note, I should be sharing it, because this was, many people don't know that I'm a bong. Bengali. I have stayed in many places. I know Hindi, English. I also know to speak and understand Tamil language. And this was one skill I learned in Chetpet, because when I went to the Chetpet store, I was the first who was in a North Indian Tamil Nadu mein aaya tha. So for the first North Indian store manager of that store, and the first few weeks I had a really tough time, because everybody would feel that ye to bahar ka aadmi hai. Nobody would, if I speak to them in English, they would, some of them would speak to me in English, some of them would purposefully not speak to me in English, and they would continue speaking to me in Tamil. And my first unit HR, he told me that, sir, if you want to stay here for long and get the team into your confidence, learning Tamil would be extremely crucial for you. So I started learning the language with him and my unit coordinator, and these two people used to in the afternoon give me coachings on Tamil, ye bolo wo bolo, and sab is. And in the initial few days, I remember one of the Saturday meetings, the first Saturday meeting, my unit chair told me, today you will start with by saying vanakkam. Vanakkam in Tamil is, yeah, namaste or something like that. And I, in my broken whatever way, I told them, and I still remember the face of the store team. They were all laughing, ki ye kya bol diya isne. So that store gave me a lot of learning. I picked up a new language, and but Chetpet was a very short stint for me. I spent I guess 12-13 months, a quick fire 12-13 months in this store, and I was given the opportunity to move to a much larger store, that was Bannerghatta in Bangalore. And coming from Chetpet to Bannerghatta, the business size was four times what I used to handle, and the team size was also much larger. But I think as a team in Bannerghatta, we really did well during those years, and whatever I had learned from the Chetpet store in Shopper Stop in retailing really helped me to work with my team. Fantastic teamwork we had there. And we really clocked some new milestones, be it in sales, profitability, ASI, CSI. And there was one year in 2008, I remember, the Bannerghatta store used to be extremely, extremely profitable. It still is a very profitable store. And I remember the CEO that time telling me that the Bannerghatta store annual profitability for that year was actually 12% of the chain numbers. So it was, and that time I think in the chain we had some 17-18 stores. It was a small company that year. So I spent another 12-13 months in Bannerghatta, and then I got the opportunity to sit in the area controller assessment. So the organization had rolled out an area controller assessment, keeping in mind that huge expansions were planned in the next 3 to 5 years. So I cleared the assessment, and I was given Karnataka that time, and it was a different era altogether. Though it was Karnataka area controller, but we just had three stores. So one was Garuda, Bannerghatta, and Homestop in just opposite the Garuda store. So there were three stores. But the journey thereafter was super fast. So from the time I took over and from the time I left, I had an opportunity to roll out 15 new stores in that area in South. So new stores was a big learning, adding new team members, and then with every store the team strength multifold. So had a huge, large team. So again, as I always keep saying that, for me in this role, it's all about managing, or I would say leading the team, because I do not have to tell them what they're supposed to do. They have been hired and they know what they have to do. I think just making sure that they are in the right direction and aligning them to the corporate strategies and changes which we keep doing. I think that's the key for the role. So yeah, Bangalore, so area controller, and I was there till 2017, and that was about 12 years I've spent in Bangalore. Me and family have stayed there for 12 years, and we were actually feeling very comfortable, and Bangalore had become my hometown. Every year I used to come once to meet my parents in Delhi, and then suddenly I was thrown this opportunity of coming to North. And I still believe, I still remember that I took the decision from the time they told me in the company. I took just 5 minutes and said, yes, I will go. And I think the people who were telling me this were also equally surprised that having stayed so long in a place, and I was like, okay, let's go to North, because I was never scared of, and I'm still not scared of any changes which happen or are supposed to happen, be it professionally or be it personally. And in quick time, I think in a span of 40-45 days, with bag, baggage, family, new house, new school, and new office, I was in Noida. So 2017 is when I came to Noida. Initially, I used to handle, I don't remember if it was North 1 or North 2, I don't remember exactly the number, but I was handling a part of North. And after a few months, the zonal controller position was envisaged by the management. And then I was given the role of leading this fantastic team in North. And I should say, what a team and what a dream run it has been from there on. I think so. Personally, I think my strength comes from my team. They truly and sincerely inspire me to keep working hard and to keep working relentlessly, because that's how my team is. And it's all about collaboration within all the team members, so that we can take care of our internal and external customers as best as we can. So that was my, I think, quick one on my professional journey. I remember Prerna, you were asking me about some time back about work stress. I really, to be true, I really don't feel stressed. I know that whenever I'm stressed, I always tell myself, aaj raat ko so jao, sleep over it. Tomorrow is a new day. So whenever I am stressed, few of the times I am stressed, I always feel, let's hit the pillow. Aaj raat ko is problem pe so jao. Tomorrow will be a new day, and I'm sure there'll be some solution for it. So I personally don't, I would not say I don't take stress, but I don't feel stressed because I have an internal mechanism which, as every one of us have ways and means to cope up with things. So I have an internal mechanism where I know where to switch on and where to switch off myself. So I believe in that space which I carry. I think I don't personally or professionally get into a tight spot because I believe that as much we can plan and organize, though things are very unpredictable, and COVID has been a classical example where whatever we had thought and planned for ourselves, our lives, everything has been just thrown out of the window. But I think as much we can plan and organize ourselves, I think the stress is that much less. So the more we plan, the more we organize, the more we think about the contingencies and again plan for it, it really adds more time to the clock and helps you to de-stress. And the more organized I think and I feel like I can keep myself, the more organized my team would be around, because time is one thing which is a big factor in all our lives, be it professionally, be it personally. managing the ticking clock is a big challenge. So and I think each one of us, many times people walk up to me and ask me that how am I able to do a certain thing in a certain time, or how do I have such a strong follow-up mechanism. I think everybody should, I have my own method and system to plan and organize myself, remind myself, and using technology, be it your phone, be it many apps which remind us many things, be it the calendar. These are all gadgets and tools which, if we understand their power, we can actually use them very effectively to organize and manage ourselves. So befriending a watch is a very important skill for all of us. Just 24 hours, couple of years in life, I think that's what is important. And personally, I don't get into too much of stresses, because I can find humor in anything and everything around me. I can joke out of anything and everything. I think that's something. And that keeps my mind light overall. But sometimes I think people may get offended with what I tell, but I know that I never mean, or I never have any ulterior motives, or I don't mean any bad to anyone in my jokes. So humor going and keeping myself light. Wow, I've spoken a lot. Prerna, all yours.
What an inspirational journey, sir, for us to know, sir. I would want to congratulate you also on completing 15 years with Shoppers Stop. It had been an inspiration for all of us and many of us watching you live today. Sir, we also wanted to know, who is your inspiration?
अगर मेरी वाइफ आसपास होती ना तो उसका नाम ले लेता हूँ. She would have felt nice. Okay. So actually, I do not have a name. I don't know. I can't say I'm inspired by one person or two person. So I'm not inspired by a single person. But I love reading biographies and autobiographies of various people from various walks of life. I think each of them have so many interesting things from their life to share with us, and for me to learn from this book. So for me, inspirations are all these big or renowned people from various walks of life. And I generally go through these biographies and autobiographies, and recently during these lockdowns, on all these OTT channels, there were many of these documentaries of renowned people from various walks of life, which I used to see. And there are so many things to learn from them. I especially liked reading these two gentlemen, Jack Welch and Steve Jobs, their autobiographies. And currently, not that I'm a very vociferous reader, but I generally I'm not able to complete a book very soon, so your time like that. But currently, I'm reading this book from Mr. APJ Abdul Kalam Azad, Wings of Fire. So that's one book currently which I take in the night and go to sleep and try to read some of the pages. Really inspiring character. From the way he started and he reached the top of in the country. So
so you've talked about sticking to basics in our previous conversation. So as we are gradually adapting to the new normal, any mantra that you could share for us to follow as we keep moving forward?
I think, yeah, I don't know, be normal, then it is new normal, and now there are people saying next normal. So I don't know, I think everything is normal, whatever is happening around us. But one thing, whatever the terminology we use, but I think one thing, the mantra for me is that I like to keep myself sharp by continuous learning from every opportunity I get. I try to learn from every person whom I connect with. I try to learn what he or she has to say. I think learning can be endless and should not stop, and we should be a student of our domain and student of our life always. So there is no end to learning. So that's my mantra. And another thing I strongly live by is this is the tagline for I think Nike, which says just do it. So that's my philosophy, just do it. I don't like to paralyze myself with the situations around me. I always like to keep in motion. It's very important that I keep myself in motion, and busy and holding up is a big dampener, and I don't like to be stuck in a place. So just doing it. Sometimes I do make mistakes, and I have made mistakes, but I'm like, okay, mistake is made. I have learned it, and now let me do it again. Do it, and this time I will not make that mistake. So continuously being in motion and doing things is another mantra I sincerely believe. So keep learning, keep in motion, just keep doing things, and keep learning from it again. Yes, Prerna.
Keep learning, sticking to basics, and keep in motion. The mantra for all of us to follow. So we had a long queue of questions, but the time is ticking fast. So with this, we would come to the end of this wonderful inspirational session. Thank you so much, sir, for your time. Thank you, lovely audience. I'm sure we have a lot many takeaways from the session today. Thank you, everyone, once again. Have a great evening ahead. Namaste.
Thank you.